inspired word and worship,
inviting evangelism, innovative discipleship,
invested lifestyles of salvation, holiness, stewardship, and service.
And God,
and God,
and God,
and God will grant the increase.
Greetings. My name is Marvin. Thanks for joining our virtual service. Here at New Creation Christian Fellowship, you will experience the kind of word and worship that's transforming, that will meet you where you are, develop your character, and change your life forever. So again, welcome to New Creation Christian Fellowship, where we transform lives through Jesus Christ.
Come on, clap those hands if you really love Jesus. As you make your way back to your seats, tell your neighbor, this is the day that the Lord has made, and I choose to rejoice in him. Come on, tell your neighbor, this is the day that the Lord has made, and I choose to rejoice in him. Come on, find one more person and tell them as you stand on your feet, this is the day that the Lord has made. I choose to rejoice in him. This is our Founders Day Sunday. Come on, let's make some noise for our founders. Clap those hands like you really mean it. We're gonna sing some songs that just encourage us to keep moving forward. Tell your neighbor, keep moving forward. Come on, put your hands together all over the building. Clap your hands right here. Come on, you gotta put your hands on that right there. Hey, yeah. Yeah, yeah. Come on, repeat after me right here. I don't know how I made it here. I know it was by the grace of God. I don't know how I made it here. I know it was by the grace of God. Come on, declare that all together. Said, I don't know how I made it here, yeah. I know it's by the grace of God. I don't know how I made it here, yeah. I know it's by the grace of God. Come on, listen to this. Said, I've made it. Come on, declare it. Said, I'm here. Yeah. Come on, declare it. Said, I've made it. Said, I'm here. One more time, take it back to the top. Hey, said, I don't know how I made it here, yeah. I know it's by the grace of God. Yeah, yeah. I don't know how I made it here, yeah. I know it's by the grace of God. Break the music. Come on, declare it all over the building. Say, I don't know how I made it here, yeah. I know it was by the grace of God. Hey! Said, I don't know how I made it here, yeah. Said, I know it's by the grace of God. Come on, all together. Hey! Said, I made it. Come on, we declare it. Said, I'm here. Come on and declare it. Said, I made it. Said, I'm here. We got another one for you. Come on, put those hands together right here. Said, I made it out. Come on, declare, I made it out all right. Yeah. I made it out all right. Help me say. Come on, testify. I made it out all right. Said, I made it. I made it out all right. Come on, thank you because you didn't leave me nor forsake me. Come on, thank you because you didn't let my enemies take me. Said, I'm still in the fight. Said, I made it out. Come on, we're going to take it to the top one more time. Come on, everybody sing this morning. Said, I made it. Made it out. I made it out all right. Hey. I made it out all right. Ooh, I, yeah. I made it out all right. Yeah, yeah. Help me, I made it out all right. Everybody say thank you. You didn't leave me. Say thank you because you didn't let my enemies take me. Come on, I'm still in the fight. Hey, said I made it out. Come on, we're going to take it to the bell. Help me declare this morning all over the building. Said I made it. I made it out all right. Said I made it. Hey, I made it out all right. Through the storm and the rain. Hey, I made it out all right. With my hands lifted up, yeah. Hey, I made it out all right. With my mouth filled with praise. Hey, I made it out all right. Said I made it. I made it out all right. Thank you because you didn't leave me nor forsake me. Said thank you because you didn't let my enemies take me. Said I'm still in the fight. Said I made it out. Come on, we got another one for you. Come on, let us encourage you right here. I'm still standing. I'm still standing. Come on, I'm still trusting.
I'm still
trusting. Said I'm still holding on.
I'm still holding
to what I believe. Come on, tell your neighbor, still motivated.
Fully persuaded.
Come on, put harmony on that. I'm still standing.
I'm still standing.
Standing on the word. Standing on.
I'm still standing.
I'm still standing on the word, yeah. Said
I'm still
standing. Said on the word, yeah.
On the word.
That's in my heart.
It's in my heart.
Say, oh, oh,
oh, oh,
oh. It's in my heart.
It's in my heart.
We're gonna declare it one more time. Oh, oh, oh. Said I'm still standing.
I'm still standing.
Come on, tell your neighbor, I'm still trusting.
I'm still.
Said I'm still holding on
to
what I believe. Come on, tell your neighbor,
still motivated,
fully persuaded. Come on, say I'm still standing.
Stand.
Said standing on your word, yeah. I'm still standing. Come on, standing on your word, yeah. Said I'm still. On your word. Say I never lost my hope. Come on, y'all declare with us this morning. I never lost my joy.
I never lost my joy.
Come on, sing it. Come on, declare. I never lost my faith.
I never lost my faith.
But most of all.
But most of all.
I never lost my praise.
I never lost my.
Come on, we gonna take it up all together. Hey. I never lost my hope, yeah.
I never lost my hope.
Come on and declare it in this building this morning. I never lost my joy, yeah.
I never lost my joy.
Come on, we're declaring it after all this time. I never lost my faith.
I never lost my faith.
One more time, but most of all.
But most of all.
Say right there, I never lost my praise.
I never lost my praise.
We're going to sing it one more time. We're going to break the music. Hey. Said I never lost my hope.
I never lost my hope.
Come on, stay right there. Hey, say I never lost my joy.
I never lost my joy.
Come on, declare. Say I never lost my faith.
I never lost my faith.
Most of all,
but most of all,
I never lost my praise.
I never lost my praise.
Come on, we got one more for you on this morning. Come on, put those hands together. Here we go. Say, the best.
The best.
Come on, declare. Is yet.
Is yet.
Say, to come.
To come.
The best.
The best.
Come on and declare it all over the building. Say, is yet.
Is
sing that
is
one more time.
To come.
Say, the best.
The best.
Say, put your hands on that right there. Is yet.
Is yet.
To come.
To come.
Come on, sing it, the best.
The best.
Is yet to come.
The best is yet to come.
Come on, help me declare. Today is the first day.
Today is the first day.
yell it. Today is the first day. Come on, sing it all together. Today is the first day. Today is the first day.
Today is the first day of the best days of
your
life.
Come on, find you a neighbor and look at them and declare, today is the first day.
Today is the first day of the best days of
come
your
on, we grooving and praising all day. Today is the first day.
Today is the first day of the best days.
Come on, all together. Since the best.
The best.
Come on, we declare that all day. Your hands like you're really glad. Come on, we gonna celebrate Jesus all day for where he's brought us from. Come on, we gonna be prophetic right here. Come on, sing with us on this morning. Said
you ain't
seen nothing. Said
you ain't seen nothing.
Said you ain't said seen nothing. The music. Said
you ain't
seen nothing.
See nothing.
Said
you ain't seen nothing.
Yet. Said you ain't said
see nothing.
You ain't. We gonna let the music play. Come on, put your hands together right here. Hey. Come on, we gonna make some noise this morning. One more time, everybody.
You ain't
seen nothing.
You ain't
said see nothing. You ain't. Let's take it up.
You ain't see nothing.
You ain't seen nothing yet. Said
you ain't
said see nothing.
You
ain't. Take it back down. Said
see nothing.
Come on, be prophetic and tell your neighbor. Said
you ain't
said see nothing.
You ain't.
Come on, let's take it out.
Hey,
the best. Come on, declare it. Say,
is yet
to come.
The best.
Here we go. The best. You don't mind for the next 30 seconds. Come on, give God your best praise this morning. Come on, give him your best praise this morning. Give him your best praise this morning. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor one more time, I don't know what you come to do, but I come to praise the name of Jesus. Come on, tell your neighbor, I come to clap my hands. I come to do my dance. I come to give him my best praise. Focus your attention towards our big screens.
Good morning, New Creation. My name is Peyton Washington.
And I'm Mariana Tota. Stay tuned for our video announcements.
Our next Shepherd's Call will be Saturday, May 4th at 10:30 a.m. at the main campus in the sanctuary. All leaders in presbytery, please read chapters 3 and 4 of your book, Pastoral Theology. New Creation and the Master's Men's Ministry will be celebrating our mothers this Mother's Day with a breakfast. That's right. All mothers are welcome to come join us at 8 a.m. before service in the gym for a breakfast that morning. Can't wait to see you there. Our Pastoral Care and Counseling Department will host our second annual Get Your House in Order, a symposium on end-of-life planning and care on Wednesday, May 15th at 7 p.m. right here in the sanctuary. We will cover topics such as navigating Medicare versus Medicaid, how to obtain a power of attorney, living versus last will and testament, life insurance, and many more. This event is free and open to the public. Come and learn valuable information that will assist you and your loved ones in getting your house in order. For questions, please email Elder Jessica at pastoralcare@nccf-sa.org or call 210-646-7997, extension 126. The NCCF Pastoral Care Department will host the second quarter Grief and Loss Seminar in person on Saturday, May 18th from 10 a.m. to 2 p.m. If you know someone who could benefit from attending this one-day session, please register by emailing Elder Jessica at pastoralcare@nccf-sa.org by or before Thursday, May 16th. The NCCF Singles Ministry will be holding its next Lunch and Learn financial training class on Saturday, May 25th at 11 a.m. It is absolutely free to everyone. Please register online at nccfonline.org. The Two Become One Marriage Ministry has something planned for all the married couples out there. Come to The Color of Love. It is a painting and dinner event right here in the NCCF cafeteria on May 25th. Please look out for registration information as it will be opening very soon. The Political Action Committee would like to inform you of some May elections for this year. On May 4th, there will be a municipal election. Early voting has already started on April 22nd and will end April 30th with Election Day on Saturday, May 4th. Also, there's a May 28th runoff election. Early voting will start May 20th through May 24th, with Election Day being on Tuesday, May 28th. And let's remember, your vote counts.
Hey church, don't forget to mark your calendars for July 16th through 19th for VBS. Volunteer signups are going to be happening next week.
Good news. Those who sign up to join the Cradle Club will begin serving in June. Trainings begin May. And children and teen baptism will resume May 26th for Family Sunday.
Amen. Come on and put your hands together in this place. Come on and bless God in this place. This is the day that the Lord has made. I know we've already opened the service with song this morning, but I don't know about you, but I've come to bless and magnify the name of the Lord. Look at your neighbor and tell them this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Tell your neighbor on the other side, oh, magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. We've come to bless him. We've come to glorify him. We've come to lift him up. We've come to come into his presence with gladness and joy. I will enter the gates with thanksgiving, and I will come into the courts with praise. I've got clapping in my hands. I've got a dance in my feet, and I've come to magnify him. Oh, this is the day, this is the day, this is the day. Lift up your head, oh my God. All ye gates, and the King of glory, he shall come in. Who is this King of glory? It's the Lord God, strong and mighty. The Lord God that's mighty in my battle. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Yes, blessed be. Come on in this place. Ah, there we go, there we go. Hey, I feel all right now. This is the day, this is the day, this is the day, this is the day. Did anybody come to have church? Did anybody come to give God glory? Did anybody come? I just need to know. I just need to know if I'm in the right place. Did you come to lift up his name? Did you come to lay down every burden that you came in here with and lift up your hands, open up your mouth, throw back your head, and just shout hallelujah anyhow? Somebody need to bless the Lord in this place. Hey, kananase. Blessed be the name of the Lord. I don't care what you came in here with. I hear the Lord saying, you just leave it right here. I don't care what chain the enemy has tried to bind you with. I hear that we plead the blood of Jesus right now. Every chain, every demonic force, everything that's not like God, it's got to go. You just got to lay it down and know that God is. He's more than able. He's more than able. He's more than able. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Now let's go to the Lord in prayer. Father, we thank you. God, we give you glory, honor, and praise. We thank you for another day. Another day that you've allowed us to come into your presence. We don't come, Lord, any kind of way, but we come submitted to you. We come with our heads bowed. We come, Lord God, into your presence with thanksgiving. We thank you for the blood of Jesus. We thank you for a right mind this morning. We thank you for a heart of worship this morning. We thank you, Lord God, for the blood that covers every sin. We thank you, Lord God, for the blood that orders our steps. We thank you, Lord God, for making our crooked pathways straight. We thank you, Lord God, for watching over your word to perform it in our lives. We thank you, Lord God, for we walk in victory today, and we give you all the glory, the honor, and the praise. Now, Holy Spirit, have your way in this place. May God be glorified and the devil be horrified at what God is getting ready to do in this place. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. We give you all the praise. In the mighty name of Jesus, we do pray and we say thank God. Thank God. Amen and amen. Now come on and put your hands together and bless God in this place. Come on. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Well, good morning, New Creation Christian Fellowship. All of our members and friends, it is Founders Day. We come to worship and magnify God, but we also thank God for the founders of this house, the Archbishop David Michael Copeland and Pastor Claudette Anderson Copeland, Pastor Emerita. We thank God. Come on, everybody ought to be on their feet, clapping and praising God for all he has done. Listen, we're so glad that each of you joined us this morning for worship, and we know that you could have chosen any place. You could have been anywhere this morning, but you chose to be right here with us. And Archbishop and Pastor, we thought so much of y'all. Pastor Regina and I shut down Northwest today. And Northwest is in the house to worship and magnify you. Because listen, y'all, whether you know it or not, it was in February of 2015. If it had not been for them, there would be no Northwest. There would be no New Braunfels. There would be nothing that's going on here without them. And so we thank God for them, and we want to encourage you, those that are online, you're watching us. Listen, you still have time to get here where the Lord is doing a great work in this place.
But if you won't come, listen, continue to keep it right there. Stay with us, because there is a great word from a woman of God for the house today. And we want you to stay tuned. Listen, we want to thank you if you're visiting with us for the first time online. Thank you so much. Drop something in the chat. Let us know that you are joining us for worship for the first time. And those, you may be, there may be someone here in the house. If you're visiting with us for the first time, would you stand real quick? Would you stand real quick? If you're visiting with us, come on. Yeah. You may have received something. Just remain standing real quick. On behalf of our Archbishop Copeland and Pastor Emerita Copeland, thank you so much for being with us today. Take just a moment. Fill that card out. You can drop it at our front desk on your way out, and we will have a little gift for you. But we thank you so much for joining us here at New Creation Christian Fellowship. Listen, we're going to go ahead on with the service this morning. We have our statement of occasion this morning by our very own Sister Deidre Cockfield. Come on, put your hands together. Bless God for her as she comes.
Good morning. Today we gather with hearts full of gratitude and reverence to celebrate a remarkable milestone in the journey of faith, service, and leadership. On this auspicious occasion of Founders Day, we pay tribute to two extraordinary pillars of our community, Archbishop David Michael Copeland and Pastor Emerita Claudette Copeland. For nearly four decades, the Copelands have illuminated our lives with their unwavering dedication, boundless compassion, and profound wisdom. Their journey of service began with a vision deeply rooted in faith and a commitment to uplift and empower every soul they touched. Through their tireless efforts, they have woven a tapestry of compassion, kindness, and justice, enriching the lives of countless individuals and families, including mine, within our community. From founding transformative outreach programs to spearheading initiatives like today, the Copelands have been steadfast advocates for the marginalized and voiceless, embodying the essence of servant leadership. Their legacy resonates in the countless lives that have touched and the transformative impact they have had on our community. Beyond the confines of our church walls, their light shines brightly, illuminating pathways of hope, healing, and reconciliation. As we commemorate 39 years of exemplary leadership, let us reflect on the myriad of achievements and milestones that bear testament to the unwavering commitment to service. Let us celebrate the lives transformed, the hearts uplifted, and the community strengthened through their visionary leadership and boundless love. As we honor Archbishop and Pastor Emerita, let us reaffirm our commitment to carry forward the torch of their legacy, to continue the work they have so passionately championed, and to illuminate the spirit of compassion and service that defines their remarkable journey. May their legacy continue to inspire us, guide us, and remind us of the profound impact that one dedicated soul can have on the world. Together, let us celebrate the extraordinary journey of Archbishop David Michael Copeland and Pastor Emerita Claudette Anderson Copeland, and the enduring legacy of love, faith, and service they have bestowed upon all of us. And personally, Bishop, Pastor, on behalf of the Waltons and the Cockfields, we are so tremendously grateful for you. My parents joined New Creation when I was only a year old. I am now 40. I did all the things New Creation. I went to the Academy, Girl Scouts, Missionettes, all that stuff. Received scholarships for college, left for school, came back, got my life right. Met my husband. Now we have Rob, remember, not Paul, Rob. Pastor and Bishop prayed me through. You all know my testimony for my babies. And now Braden is worshiping every Sunday. Brielle debuted her dancing ministry last Sunday. And so we're just super grateful. Bishop and Pastor have been there for everything. They helped bury my oldest brother. I remember when my dad was hurt and standing in a hallway and hearing footsteps and Bishop walking around the corner to support us in that traumatic time. We're just super grateful for their commitment to my family, and we just love you. So thank you.
Amen. Come on and bless God for Sister Cockfield. Clap for her. Did y'all hear what she said? She said she came back and got it right. Pastor Bishop, we still waiting on a whole lot of them to come back and get it right. But that's all right. That's all right. You got time. Keep coming. Keep coming. Listen, just a few observations real quick before our bishop and our pastor come. We want to thank everyone who donated the non-slip socks on throughout New Creation Christian Fellowship. You all are the bomb diggity. We thank you so much. Listen, we were able to go yesterday on our outreach over on the northwest side with more than 500 pair of non-slip socks. And we were there and we were able to have a great time of fellowship, a little service with the residents that were there. And it was a wonderful time to see the residents singing and clapping and worshiping with us in that time, and to go to the rooms and say a little prayer with them and just be with them for a moment. It made a difference. But we could not have done it without you, New Creation Christian Fellowship. And we are so thankful, so thankful. Listen, we want you to make sure you join our pastors online via Facebook and YouTube on Wednesday nights. How many of you have been with the Bible studies throughout this month? The audacity of talking about abiding. And we want you to continue to do that. Join us on Wednesday, 7 p.m., not here in the sanctuary, but online. And let's hear and listen for what God is getting and continuing to do for us here at New Creation. We're inviting all of our mothers to our Mother's Day Appreciation Breakfast. That will be Sunday, May the 12th. And it will be from 8 a.m. to 9:30. And it will be in the gymnasium. We ask that you please just go register at the website online, nccfonline.org, if you plan to attend. So come on, go get signed up, and let's come and have a great time with our mothers on that morning. Somebody say Kingdom Conference 2024. My goodness, the Kingdom Conference is right around the corner, and NCCF, we need you to come and get signed up to serve as drivers, hospitality, daytime greeters, armor bearers, evening and children church workers, adjutants. Y'all know you always do the best, New Creation Christian Fellowship, and so we're looking for you to get signed up for Kingdom Conference, and we want you to get registered for the conference. Early registration to attend the conference ends June the 1st. And I do believe it's only $100. It's just $100 for the early registration. You have until June the 1st, but after June the 1st, the cost is going to go up. So let's get registered and let's come to the Kingdom Conference this year. Amen? Amen. Listen, let's jump up on our feet real quick. All over the sanctuary, let's put our hands together and let's welcome our pastors, our overseers, our leaders, the Archbishop David Michael Copeland and Pastor Emerita Claudette Anderson Copeland.
Love you.
Savior died down where for cleansing from sin I cried. There to my heart
was the blood applied.
about.
Singing what?
Singing
glory to his name.
I was so wondrously
saved from sin.
Jesus so sweetly,
Jesus so sweetly
abides within.
He abides within.
Down at the cross.
Down at the cross.
Where he took me
where
in.
He took me in.
We're singing
glory to his name.
I'm singing
glory to his name, precious name.
I'm singing
glory to his name.
Where
there to my heart was a blood of life. Glory to his name.
Clap your hands and sing it.
I'm singing
glory to his name, precious name. Glory to his name.
Yeah.
Yeah, to my heart was the blood of light.
Singing
glory to his name.
Well, happy anniversary to everybody. You looking wonderful today. How are you?
Glory. Praise the Lord, saints.
Glory. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
God bless you all this morning. What a joy it is to be one more time in the house of the Lord. We thank God for our members that are with us online, all of our e-members, all of those who could not be in the house of the Lord this morning, but you've been so faithful to stay with us on the vehicles of technology. We praise the Lord for you. When we started this thing 40 years ago, there was no such thing as a screen and technology, and we had to do the best we could. But touch your friend, say, God has blessed, even when it wasn't our best, and has brought us all the way.
In the early days of our church, we did a whole lot of praying and fasting and shutting in. I remember there was one weekend we were shutting in, and in the middle of the night, there was a knock on our door over at 15...
12525
Nacogdoches. And it was a family that came knocking on the door, and they said, well, we want to come in. And we asked, so why you want to come? And they said, we were all the way on the other side of town, and we saw a fire that hung over this place, and we wanted to find out what it was. We were praying and seeking God for miracles, signs, and wonders. And we have continued to seek God for the people of God so that he might bless us and our families in everything we say and do. And it looks to me like Now Word.
Now Word family just walked in the house.
Done shut.
Praise the Lord.
Now, for those of you who don't know it, Pastor Keith Graham was the first elder that went out and started a church coming out of New Creation. And they are doing a marvelous
job.
Tremendous. In fact, one scripture said it is marvelous in our eyes.
Bishop hasn't had the microphone in a long time, so he forgot I was standing up here with him. We thank God for our man of God being healthy enough and whole enough and strong enough to stand this morning behind his pulpit. We thank God. Is Sister Slater here this morning? Is Sister Monique here? No, Brother Slater's here.
Yeah, this, for those of you who can't read, this. It says, I'm saved by Jesus and my kidney donors. So we just want to thank God for Sister Slater.
Yes, amen. Yes, yes. Amen. And for Brother Slater, who stood with us in allowing this to happen. We're so grateful to the Lord and for you who prayed us through. So grateful to the Lord and for you who prayed for my husband during this whole time. I've got a quick testimony, but I'm going to give it after I give my little remarks, because I'm going to have to sit down after that. We had an amazing time yesterday over at the Antioch Baptist Church. Walters, you all are magnificent. Our deacons, our elders, our WARE volunteers, we serve that community. And every single thing that you see out on the grounds today, we did it over there, just in miniature form. And we were able, with the partnership of Pastor Ken Kemp and the Antioch family, to serve that part. And there you have some of the footage that's there. They were amazing. Our vendors who helped the people understand the benefit of living a long time, exercise, diet, screening. It was just an amazing time, and the community came together to serve those who were underserved. We thank God for every one of you who pray for us and who continue to hold up the arms of the wellness ministry. The Lord is blessing us. One of the brothers, one of the, what do you call them, congressmen, somebody, you know, one of the important people, said, what we want to do, Pastor Copeland, if you don't mind, he said, we want to make this an official part of Fiesta every year. I said, well, let's see. Let's see. So thank you, everyone who cares, who prays, who works. Half of our members are not in the sanctuary today because they're out there putting up poles in the thunder and in the lightning, and the wonderful deacons and every one of you, thank you in advance for what you do. Sometime you got to know that man won't pay you, but God will. God will pay you back. God will pay you back. Thank you so much for all that you do. And today we're going to be on the grounds right after the benediction. I hope you brought somebody with you that we could serve you. I said to the people yesterday, if you take care of it on the front end, you won't need a miracle on the back end. We're trying to help you on the front end to live a long time. So clap your hands for yourself, for each of you that have served.
One of the reasons, one of the good things that comes out of these events, if it had not been for wellness doing this for us, I never would have known, number one, how much trouble I was in with my kidney. I never would have known what it takes. I didn't know. But when these events are scheduled with our church and by our church, it gives you an opportunity to make sure of the unseen issues that may be going on in your life. And remember, I found out I was in trouble in August. In August, weighed 264 pounds. The doctor said to go on a different diet, and I'm now 220 pounds. But the miracle was that because of Sister Slater and because of the prayers of the saints, on December the 12th, I got a kidney transplant, and I went to the doctor last week, and he told me I'm still doing good. So we thank God. Amen. Amen.
Touch three people and say, won't he do it? Ask somebody else, won't he do it? Won't he do it? Hallelujah. Oh, my, my, my. This is Founders Day. Rob Cockfield, don't you do that, brother. Sister Deetra, thank you for that great tribute. And your words have meant so much. They are the words of so many who were born in this church, who were raised in this church, who went away to do well and who continue to be connected to this church, those who were babies here and who are now grown folks and made me and Bishop spiritual grandparents because of your steadfastness. We honor every one of you. And if you're here today and you were one of the original founders, if you joined this church 1985, 86, or 87, so many of you may be online. Many of our people are infirm and not able to come. But if you're in one of those original first 36 months, I want you to stand and wave your hand if you can. Original members still here. Original members still here. Look at them. They're still 39 years. 37, 36. Praise the Lord for you. We honor you, every single one. And maybe next year at our 40th, we'll be able to take y'all somewhere. I don't know, you know. Keep living and keep watching and keep giving. We want to celebrate next year in a marvelous, marvelous way. Listen. Thank you also for those who carried the pulpit the last couple of weeks. Elder Sherman, thank you. Who else was here? Elder, who else preached? I can't hear you.
Sister Love.
Oh, Minister Natasha Love. That's right. Somebody else. Elder Randy Williams, praise the Lord for your word and your steadfastness. Thank God for every one of you who held the pulpit. I miss somebody. But let me just tell you this, and then I'm going to go into my seat. It's going to be time to pray. We're praying for Pastor Regina. She had a fall yesterday, a bad fall. Pastor Keith, you done fired that house up in here today. The Northwest on fire. I see you done brought some of that fire over here. Amen. Stake it. We need it. But listen, I want to tell you, the Lord is good to us, and we're here simply because God is so kind and merciful. 2 weeks ago, I called the elders in the back after service. I said, I need to see all the elders because the Bible says, if there's any sick among you, any afflicted, call for the elders of the church. Let them pray over you and anoint you with oil in the name of the Lord Jesus. And the Lord will raise you up. Didn't I? Y'all who were here, who know? I called him in the back. I said, I need you to pray for me. I'm not noising anything abroad because, you know, people have you dead before you really are. I said, I just need you to pray for me. I went into the doctor's office a couple of weeks ago, and for one thing, just a simple scan of my heart. And they called me back immediately. They said, Reverend Copeland, we see something in your chest and it's not right. I said, okay then. They called me back for another scan with contrast. We want to see what this thing really is. There's something going on between your heart and your breastbone. It is a mass in your chest and it does not look right. I said, okay, well, let's keep looking. But meanwhile, I call for the elders of the church. Meanwhile, I did what the Bible said. Let them anoint you with oil and pray over you. And the prayer of faith, hallelujah, my. I went into the hospital the day after the elders prayed for me and prayed with me. Hallelujah. The doctor said, well, we're going to do what we can do. We're going to pray that we don't have to open your chest and cut you down the middle. So we're going to do something laparoscopically. And they put three incisions in my side with a camera. And they went in and they found this mass between my heart, my breastbone, and my lungs. And they got whatever it is out of my chest. And the doctor said, he said, you're going to be sore for a little while. He said, but from what we can tell, it is not malignant. It is benign. Because I call for the elders of the church to pray over me and anoint me with oil. And the prayer of faith would raise me up. And I'm here today to tell you, it is no secret what God can do, what he's done for others. What he's done for others. I'm sore, but I'm here. I got scars, but I'm here. I'm hurting a little bit, but I'm here. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on and help me praise him. Help me glorify him. Hallelujah. Won't he lift
lift your bowed down head? Won't he touch your body when you need it most? Won't he make a way for you? Glory, 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 glory. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Somebody needs this morning. Somebody needs a word of hope. Somebody needs to have your faith encouraged. Somebody needs your faith to be strengthened. Come on and worship him. My. Oh, God. Until God says something else for you, we gonna live. Yeah. I don't know what you're looking at me for. You better worship him. Glory, 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 glory. Glory, 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 glory,
glory. I heard, you heard of debit cards? Debit cards is where you got money laid up, so whenever you need it, you already got it. Would you give God a debit card praise?
Me this morning. Come on, come on, come on. We're praying. We're praying. We're lifting up the name of Jesus in this house this morning. I don't know about you, but in this house, New Creation Christian Fellowship Church, miracles are happening. Why? Because we serve a God who is a miracle-working God. Miracles are in this house this morning. The Holy Spirit is in this house this morning. So as the elders and the ministers come to the altar this morning to pray with those who say, pray for me. Father God, we bless your name this morning. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Father. Oh, what a great God we serve. Father, we feel your Holy Spirit in this place this morning. Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, we call upon you right now. Rain down in this service this morning. Rain down on your elders this morning. Rain down on your people this morning. Move by your Spirit in this house. We thank you, Holy Spirit, this morning. Oh, we know you can do miracles. And so we come confessing, oh God, that we need a miracle. We need a breakthrough this morning, God. Somebody needs a deliverance this morning, oh God. So come now. Do what you do. Oh God, turn people around. Turn circumstances around. Save those that are not saved, God. Deliver those who need deliverance. Oh God, pull out of the snare those who are stuck, God. Those who are in the muck and the mire, oh God. We thank you right now, Holy Spirit. Move, direct, convict in the name name of Jesus. Only you can do it. Raise up now in your people, God. Raise up, oh God, in the speaker today. Hallelujah. Oh, touch her body this morning, God. Touch her mind this morning, oh God. Move in her body, God. Move in her speech, oh God. What the word that's coming forth in her to God tonight, today, oh God. Let it be rhema, God. Let it be mind-changing, transformational, oh God. In the name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord, for those who have come today to serve and to, oh God, celebrate our founders today, oh God, our Archbishop David Michael Copeland, God, our pastor, Reverend Dr. Claudette Anderson Copeland, oh God. We thank you, God, for their service, oh God. We thank you, Lord, for their dedication, God. We thank you, Lord, for their faithfulness, oh God. So keep moving in their lives, oh God. This initiative this morning, God, we lift it up to you, oh God, in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord, that the rain will not hinder. Oh God, we thank you that the people are coming, Lord God. We thank you, Lord, that the people will be healed, informed, oh God, about wellness, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, this house gets in alignment with this initiative today, God. We all, oh God, are on one accord this morning, God. There will be unity, oh God. There will be love spread abroad, oh God. The people who do not know you, Lord, will know you, God, by how we love on one another today. Oh God, oh my God, we thank you and we glorify you this day, Lord. Answer every prayer petition, Lord, that is at this altar today, oh God. We know you're mighty, we know you're great, we know you're a good God, and so we stand in faith to you today, oh God, trusting and believing, God, that you're gonna do it again, Lord, just like you've done in past times. And we give your name the praise, honor, and the glory. Glory, God, in Jesus' name. Amen, amen, amen.
I will trust in the Lord. I will trust in the Lord. Say it with these. I will trust in the Lord. Until I die. Come on, Zion. I will trust, yeah, yeah, in the Lord. Yes, I will. I will trust in the Lord. Open your mouth and sing it. I will trust in the Lord until I die. All in the balcony, let me hear you cry it out. I'm gonna stay on the battlefield, gonna stay on the battlefield. I'm gonna stay right here. I'm gonna stay on the battlefield. Yeah, yeah, I'm gonna stay right here on the battlefield until I die. Oh, I'm gonna stay on the battlefield. Yes, I will. Yes, I will. Gonna stay on the battlefield. Yeah, I'm gonna stay on the battlefield, yeah, until I. We're gonna move on, but move out from where you are. Shake somebody's hand. They need to hear it. Tell them, trust in. Move and tell somebody, trust, trust him. He won't let you down. Trust him. I'm gonna trust him, trust him. Trust him. He won't let you down. Till I move and tell somebody. move and encourage somebody. I will trust. I'm going to trust him. I'm going to trust him. Hallelujah. Yes, I will. Yes, I will. Encourage somebody right there. Oh, my. Oh, my. I'm going to trust him. Reverend, I'm going to trust the Lord. Yeah. Till I.
Until I die, I'm gonna stay on my bending knees. I'm gonna stay on my bending knees. I'm gonna stay on my bending knees until I die.
Amen, amen. Saints of God, don't we have a wonderful community here at New Creation Christian Fellowship? Amen. As you're moving back to your seats, Saints of God, I am here because we have the profound pleasure that it is receiving time here at New Creation. Amen. For those of you in the sanctuary, if you need an envelope, please raise your hands and our ushers will assist you. And my online partners all over the nation, take the opportunity to pull out your smart devices as you too are able to participate in giving. Founders Day, right? Founders Day, Audacity 24, Ask and Ask. We have had a full month of the word abide. And so we recognize from Strong's 33 and 6 that to abide means to stay, continue, dwell, endure, tarry, represent or present, remain, stand. I want to just give one a scripture to you today from the book of Luke chapter 6, verses 47 through 49. And it's in the same line with our founders. The wise and the foolish builders. And it reads as follows. Why are you so polite with me always saying, yes, sir, and that's right, sir, but never doing the thing that I tell you? These words I speak to you are not mere additions to your life, homeowners improvements, to your standard of living. They are foundation words, words to build a life on. And it says, if you work the words into your life, you are like a smart carpenter who dug deep and laid the foundation of his house on a bedrock, so that when the rivers burst and its banks crash against the house, nothing could shake it. It was built to last. But if you use my words in Bible studies and don't work them into your life, you are like a dumb carpenter who built a house but skipped the foundation. When the swollen rivers came crashing in, it collapsed like a house of cards. It was a total loss. So, saints of God, listen to me. We have founders that have provided us with foundational words of wisdom, transformational liturgy teaching or liturgical teachings. They have tarried. You heard Sister Deidre. They have tarried, remained, endured with us, taught us how to be wise builders and not foolish ones, encouraged us through the highs of marriages and babies and the lows of lost in life. That's what our founders have been for us, such that when we, with our connection to this vine of our bishop and our pastor, are connected, we, New Creation Christian Fellowship, will produce much fruit. Please look at the big screens. to view the five ways that we give. At New Creation, we believe in the tithe. The tithe is the top 10% of your increase so that the rest can be blessed. Remember the audacity offering. Ask, see, inquire, and inspire. Act, make a bold God move. We're giving an additional $60 a month over and above our tithes and offerings. So when giving, please remember to use your full name and annotate where this giving will be applied. My online partners, now is a great time for each of you to hit your submit button. Now, saints of God in the sanctuary, later in the service, I'm going to come back. When you came in the doors, there was an opportunity to get a card that was probably in an envelope like this. If you don't have one, our ushers will be happy to serve you. Amen? So we'll be doing that a little bit later. And each of you will have an opportunity to bless our founders on this day. And they deserve to be blessed without question. So please hold up your offerings here in the sanctuary. If you would stand with me. All over the sanctuary. Lord, help us each day to abide in you such that we keep a habit of constant close communion with you, to always lean on you, to be resting on you, to pour out our hearts to you in Jesus' name. Amen? Ladies and gentlemen, let's recite our offering declaration. It should be on the screens for you. According to God's word, we believe that when we sow bountifully, we reap bountifully. We return back to God what belongs to God. And because we do, we declare that we receive more than enough for our family, our friends, our community, and our future in Jesus' name. Amen. So hold up your offerings and our ushers will now collect them for you. Pass them to the center aisles. Thank you, Pastor. Pass them to the center aisles and our ushers will be happy to serve you. Now I'm going to call up Elder Jessica Bass. God bless you all.
Praise the Lord. Thank you, New Creation, for continuing to be a generous, marvelously generous church. Those of you who have tuned in online, if this ministry continues to be a blessing to you, feel free to sow into the good work at New Creation Christian Fellowship. Amen. At this time, we're going to have a special presentation by Lady Denetrius Graham from the Now Word Christian Fellowship Church. As many of you know, Pastor Keith Graham and Lady Denetrius are the first son and daughter from New Creation Christian Fellowship, and so she's back to make a special presentation to our founders this morning. Let's receive her as she comes.
Amen, amen, amen. Amen, amen. I was so honored when Bishop said, the first folks that joined in that first 36 months, I was so honored to be able to stand up because I was sure one of them. Amen, amen. God bless you. You guys have some absolutely awesome, awesome founders. And we at Now Word Covenant Church, we love them and we will forever, forever be indebted to them. So we have a special presentation because it is Founders Day. Yes. Founders Day at NWCC. Is that right? No, I'm sorry. NCCF. I'm sorry. NCCF. Amen. God bless you. All right. Archbishop Copeland and Pastor C. I greet you in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, on behalf of myself and Pastor Keith and the Christ followers of Now Word Covenant Church. It gives us great pleasure to congratulate you on 39 years of good and faithful service as founders of New Creation Christian Fellowship. It is also special to Pastor Keith and myself because it is where we got our foundation for ministry that has been the cornerstone of our ministry at the Word. Amen. You have served, ministered to thousands, and given of yourself sacrificially and selflessly for the sake of the gospel. You have shown your love for God and for God's people. We honor your legacy, encourage you, and continue in the work of the Lord. We sow this seed in your lives as a fruit from our labor over the years to show you your labor has not been in vain. Somebody was listening. Amen. Amen. Much love from myself and your firstborn son in the ministry, Pastor Keith Graham. We love you. We honor you. And as I said, we will forever be indebted to you. God bless you.
We love you, God.
Come on, let's praise the Lord once again for Lady Denetrius Graham, Pastor Keith, and the Now Word Christian Fellowship Church. At this time, a new creation, let's receive vessels of praise, our dance ministry. Let's praise the Lord with them as they come. Amen.
Sufficiency, everything you need, everything you want, everything you need. Rekenda bashiati yorobo, rakada bashiki yerebe kureama, tatada dobo hoshike yerebe heshaya. There's a healing anointing in here. It's my desire, says the Lord, for you to be free, for you to be free. It's my desire. Saith the Lord, for you to be free, for you to be free, giving you the victory over the enemy, giving you the victory.
can heal and I can mend broken pieces. I can, if you let me, if you let me, just let me in into your heart, into your mind, no more shake it, into your heart, into your mind, into your heart, into your mind. Give me all your burdens, cast your cares on me, I care for you, I love you, even when you rebel, I'm still there, I love you, break out of shame, I love you. With an everlasting love, with an everlasting love, with an everlasting love, with an everlasting love, I love, I love. He says I love. He says I love you. Because you called on me tonight, I'm gonna fulfill every desire, and I'm gonna make every way. Because I heard your cry, because I heard your cry, because I heard your cry, because I heard your cry. All I want is for you to be glorified. All I want is for you to be glorified. All I want is for you to be glorified. Is that your desire this morning? Through the storm, through the rain, through sickness and pain, all I want is for him to be glorified. That's why we're here this morning. Young people, thank you. Brother Cliff, thank you for moving our Elevate students forward. And we are so grateful for our young people, our teenagers, college students, our high schoolers, for their part in the ministry. And we thank God for you. Well, it's preaching time. It's preaching time. Thank God that we got a new grandbaby in the house. Sister Mary Presley and Elder Presley got a new grandbaby. We're so proud. So proud of them. You know, you get a certain age, you got to say it when you remember it.
because it'll run away out your mind. But thank God our preacher is in the house this morning. And we're going to ask for an abbreviated time of worship for. We don't want Pastor Carolyn to have to sit here through more. She's a courageous, courageous warrior. She's been sitting through the service, and we don't want to tire her body. But we're so honored that she would come again. As Lady Graham has said, but our first son, really, she was the first daughter to go out and pastor successfully from this house. And she has been a mighty, mighty warrior in, I'm going to read this. Pastor Carolyn Ramsey is a native of San Antonio, Texas. She received her undergraduate degree in nursing from Prairie View A&M University. She earned a dual master's degree in religious education and community ministry from Southwestern Baptist Theological Center. Touch Your Friend says she got her learning and her burning. She was employed as an oncology and hospice nurse for many years. During her tenure, her colleagues jokingly referred to her as the PR, and that means the preaching nurse. She preached her first sermon at the New Mount Rose Baptist Church, the Fifth Sunday Missions Program, at the age of 16. Pastor Carolyn was licensed as a minister in 1990, ordained in 1993 under the authority of the New Creation Christian Fellowship under Bishop David and Claudette Copeland. In January of this year, Pastor Carolyn celebrated 31 years of her ordination. 31 years. 31 years. 1998, Pastor Ramsey accepted an assignment with a Full Gospel Baptist Church in Arkansas. She served faithfully in Arkansas for 21 years. Pastor Ramsey is the founder and pastor emerita of the Destiny Worship Center of Pine Bluff, Arkansas, and she retired from that pastorate in 2019. She strongly believes in being led by the Spirit of the Lord, and she possesses a keen prophetic ear. With the focus of an eagle's eye, she committed to completing the assignment the Lord has planned for her life. She is the proud mother of 5 living children, has 5 grandchildren, and 1 beloved goddaughter. That's what it says on the paper. For those of you who were with us in 1986, 87, 88, you watched her as she trained our missions program, as she taught the people to go out and do Meals on Wheels, how she stood by my side as we began to create a women's ministry of retreats and healing spaces outside this house. When I was diagnosed with infiltrating ductal adenocarcinoma, and the doctors said, we got to amputate your breast and pump you full of adriamycin and chemotherapy drugs, it was this woman of God who stood by me, held me up, prayed me through. And had it not been for her counsel, I probably would have been dead, because I wasn't going to the doctor like I should have gone. But we thank the Lord that all things work together for the good of those who love the Lord. And she is here today, daily gaining victory over her own battles in her own body. She'll give her own testimony if she chooses. But after we have received a short version of music from our wonderful, wonderful praise team, our wonderful praise team, a short version of music, we're going to, the next preaching voice you will hear, the next speaking voice will be that of our own Pastor Carolyn Denise Ramsey. Prepare your heart to be blessed. Clap your hands.
Come on, clap your hands for Jesus like you really mean it. We can sing this song briefly. I was up at 4 this morning and asking the Lord, what does he want us to get out of today? And the Lord reminded me of Abraham and Sarah. In the latter part of their life, he gave them a child. And what I want to just encourage each of you, you may be in the latter part of your life, but God is just about to do his best work. So we're going to declare this song very shortly. It just declares manifest to become what God's designed me to be. Come on, tell your neighbor, manifest. Come on, tell somebody else, manifest. Come on, help me praise team. The words just declare, pregnant.
Pregnant.
Possibilities.
Possibilities.
Now birth.
Now birth.
Anew.
Anew.
Travail.
To
obtain it. Come on, I'm here to declare. It must come to pass. Say, I decree it.
I decree it.
Declare it.
Declare it.
And call it.
And call it.
In the spirit.
In the spirit.
To become.
To become.
What God's design.
To me to be.
We're going to say that one more time. I declare in this room, we're pregnant with possibility.
Possibility.
Now birth.
Now birth.
Anew.
Travailing.
To obtain it.
To obtain.
For it must. Come to pass. Come on, help us declare this. Say, I decree it.
I decree it.
We declare it, yeah.
Declare it.
And we call it,
call
in,
it.
The spirit.
In the spirit
to become
what God's designed
to me to be. Yeah. Let me just sing the second verse and we're done. Hey, it says, your future. Said your promises, yeah, shall be fulfilled. Yes, you,
yes,
shall obtain it. Yeah, said
for it must
come to pass. Yeah, said I decree it. Yeah,
I decree.
Come on, tell somebody I declare it, and I call it. Yeah. Spirit, hallelujah,
spirit.
To become what God designed me to be, me to be. Come on, y'all sing it like you really mean it. We're going to break the music and declare it one more time all over the building.
Your future,
come on, declare it. Your promises,
yeah.
We declare it shall be fulfilled, hallelujah. Say yes, you. Come on, I declare, shall obtain it. Sit for it must. Hey. I declare it shall come to pass. Come on, tell your neighbor, I decree it. Come on, I declare it in the spirit. And I call it, yeah. Said in the spirit, hallelujah. We declare, I decree it, yeah. Said we declare it in the name of Jesus. And call it. Said in the spirit. Come on. Come on, prophesy. Said manifest. In the name of Jesus, we declare manifest. Said manifest. Said manifest. Yeah. Said I decree it. Said I declare it. Yeah. Said I decree it. Yeah. Said I declare.
Yeah.
Come on, declare.
It's mine.
Whatever you need.
It's mine.
Whatever you want from the Lord is yours. Call those things that are not as though they are mine. Yeah. The word of the Lord says I can have what he wants me to have. It's mine. Pretty good. Manifest.
Manifest.
Oh,
of your situation. You are not what you're going through. You are not your past failures. You are not your mistakes, so you're not. It's mine, it's mine, it's mine, mine. Yeah. I declare who God designed, yeah, yeah, me to be, yeah, yeah. I am not my mistakes. I am not my situation. You are not, yeah, yeah. Come on and declare, yeah.
One more time, to become what God designed. Said me to be, me. Come on now for the next 30 seconds. Open your mouth and declare it's gonna manifest. Come on, declare it's gonna manifest. Whatever the Lord has promised you, come on, declare one more time, it's gonna manifest. I see it. I have it. Said, I see it. Come on, declare. Said, I have it. Hey, said, I see it. Hey, said, I have it. Hey, said, I see it. Hey, I have it. Break the music. One of the things that the enemy is trying to do in this season is blind you by your problems and by your situations. But I declare on this morning that eyes will be open to see what the Lord has promised. I declare one more time, eyes will be open to see what the Lord has promised. We're going to declare it one more time all over the building. Come on, by faith, declare. Hey, say, I see it. Come on, look over your shoulder and say, I see it. Said, I see it coming here. In the name of Jesus, I see it. Said, more than you can imagine, yeah. I see better days ahead of you. Said, I see it. Come on, declare, I see it. One more time. Hey, said, it's mine. In the name of Jesus, it's mine. Said, it's mine. Take me back to the verse. Your future, your promises, they shall be fulfilled. Come on, yes, you shall obtain it, yeah. Said, for it must, hey, come to pass, yeah. Say, I decree it, yeah. One more time, declare it. And we call it, yeah, in the spirit, we out to become to what God's design sent me to be, me. Come on now, open up your mouth. If you really believe what you just declared, give God the greatest praise that you can. Come on, let's seal it by faith. Tell your neighbor, I see it, I have it. And I declare it.
Come on, you better decree a thing. Has the Lord not been good to anyone in this room? Can you see it? Do you believe it? Are you open to receive it? If so, give God some praise in this house. You may have your seats in the sanctuary. God is good, isn't he? I don't know about you all, but I am so, so very happy to be here. 39 years. Oh my God. Nitris, Lady D, I'm just like you. I was proud to put my hand up and say that I was here. We give honor to God today. Amen. Y'all excuse me while I'm trying to get situated. Who is the head absolutely of my life? It is because of the goodness of the Lord that I'm still here. Y'all take a good look. They thought I'd be gone, but I'm still here. Hallelujah. I give an honor to the Lord, to Bishop, Pastor C, amen, new creation, all of you all that are here. Hallelujah. I'm okay if I sound a little winded. I'm okay. God is good. I want to thank the Lord. I feel like I'm getting ready to cry because I would not be who I am today in God. I'm not talking about as a preacher. I'm not talking about as a pastor. I'm talking about as a believer. Hallelujah. If it had not been of what they instilled in me about living for God. Hallelujah. If you all would allow me, I want to thank the Lord for my brother, Pastor Keith Graham, and my Now Word Covenant Church family. I've known Netris because Netris and I went to, we won't say how far back, but it's far back. Before you graduate from high school, we have known each other that long. But I met Pastor Keith here, and he has been a blessing in my life. And there's a lot I cannot do, but my brother and Now Word take excellent care of me, and I'm grateful. God is good and he's worthy to be praised. Come on and look at someone to your left and right and say, it's so good to be here. Hallelujah. Is everybody ready for the word of the Lord? Need you to pray for the preacher this morning? Hallelujah. The word of the Lord this morning, I believe that the Lord has divinely given this word to me. I don't know if you all received the message to put the scripture on the screen, but those of you all that would like to know, we're going to 2 Chronicles, the 20th chapter, and we'll be reading in your hearing. We'll be reading in your hearing verses 1 through 4 and verses 13 through 15. 2 Chronicles, the 20th chapter, verses 1 through 4, and then verses 13 through 15. I see some of you all know what to do. Come on, let's stand out of honor to our Lord for the reading of his word. And it reads, amen. Someone say, after this. After this, the Moabites and the Ammonites with some of the Mennonites came to wage war against Jehoshaphat. Some of the people came and they told Jehoshaphat, a vast army is coming against you from Edom and from the other side of the Dead Sea. They are already at Hazon Tamar, that is in Gita. Alarmed, somebody say alarmed. One translation says that he was terrified. Somebody say terrified. And another translation said he was fearful. Alarmed, Jehoshaphat resolved to inquire of the Lord, and he proclaimed a fast for all of Judah. And the people of Judah came together to seek help. Somebody say help, Lord. To seek help from the Lord. Indeed, they came from every town in Judah to seek him. Verses 13 through 15. All of the men of Judah, their wives and their children and their little ones. Somebody say everybody. Everybody stood there before the Lord. Then the Spirit of the Lord came on Jehaziel, the son of Zechariah, the son of Benjamin. Now, we're going to roll over those words, okay? The son of Jael, the son of Mattaniah, a Levite, a descendant of Aspar, as he stood in the assembly, and the Bible says that he said, "Listen, King Jehoshaphat and all who live in Judah and Jerusalem, this is what the Lord wants to say to you, new creation, everybody. On this 39th celebration of Founders Day, the Lord is saying, do not be afraid and do not be discouraged because of all of the stuff that's trying to add up around you, because this battle is not yours, but this battle is the Lord's." Look at somebody to the left and to the right and encourage the founders of this church and say, don't be scared. Don't get discouraged, because this battle, this time, ain't yours. It's the Lord's. Wait a minute. Stay right there. That's our teaching text. But we have a foundational scripture, and it is found in Romans, the 10th chapter and the 17th verse. And it's from the NIV translation, and it says, "Consequently, faith comes from hearing the message, and the message is heard by the word." So if I could undergird what I'm getting ready to tell you, it would be this. It's not just that it's not your battle. This battle belongs to the Lord. But if he did it then, he'll do it again. If he did it then, and if he's done it for 39 years, he'll do it this time. Somebody shout back at me and say, this time too. Be seated in the sanctuary. Father, we tell you thank you for your great wonder. We tell you thank you, Lord, for 39 years, for the thousands of people whose lives have been impacted, for those of us that still have the opportunity to be here, and for those who would never have learned how to have a relationship with you had they never walked through the doors of New Creation Christian Fellowship. And they may be at rest and at peace and glory, but if they develop the relationship here, so, Father, we say continue this great work. We ask you to do it in Jesus' name. We ask you to bless everyone that's here. Father, we ask you to give me teaching power today. Give me strength in my body. Regulate the rhythm of every part of who I am right now. Let me speak only that you want spoken, and then let me speak it boldly. God, we thank you in advance for those that will have an ear to hear what the Spirit of the Lord would have to say. And then the courage, the audacity within their faith to obey that you're opening up for them. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. If God did it before, he'll do it again. Beloved, we're living in a time which is quite challenging. And there's one thing that I love about the Word of the Lord, is the Word of the Lord provides for each one of us a roadmap and gives us directions so that we will know which way to go. We'll know what to do. He provides for us instructions, someone say instructions, how to live peaceably while we're here on this earth. And the Lord loves each one of us so much that he puts up with all of our shortcomings. Do I have a witness in God's house? He loves us even when we don't have enough sense to love him back. The Lord has been good. What I love also about the Word of God, oh Jesus, I just saw the clock. What I also love about the Word of the Lord is the fact that God gives us examples in his Word. of people that were just like you and I. And the person that we'll be highlighting today in the teaching text is King Jehoshaphat. But let me give you just a little bit of background before we get into the 20th chapter. In the Second Chronicles, the 18th and the 19th chapter, the Bible unfolds and it talks about the relationship between King Ahab and King Jehoshaphat. The Bible declares that King Ahab was married to Jezebel. Some of you all know her, or you've heard of her. The Bible declares that she was controlling, she was manipulative, and even borderline wicked. No, that ain't true. She was manipulative, controlling, and she was wicked. The Bible declares that Ahab was weak, greedy, and he too could be manipulative. He was the king of Israel in the northern region. The Bible also talks about a man, Jehoshaphat, and the Bible declares that Jehoshaphat was the king of Judah. Somebody say Judah. He was a man, and the Bible says that he was well respected and honored. He was a God-fearing man, and he loved God, but he was not a perfect man. The Bible says that King Ahab and King, amen, Jehoshaphat, they came into an alliance together. Wait a minute. How do we come into alliance when we're God-fearing with wickedness? But the Bible declares that they came into an alliance together. Just giving a little bit of history. The Bible says it was a part of Jehoshaphat's, because the close proximity that they had one to another, that he wanted their countries to be at peace. Don't ever do just about anything just to have peace. God still has a standard. The Bible says he also did this. He gave his son to Ahab's daughter in marriage. So King Jehoshaphat's daughter was married to King Ahab and Jezebel's daughter. Watch this. Be careful who you connect your life with when you claim God as your God. The Bible says that, amen, several years after that, that, amen, Ahab had a dinner at his house. We're still in the 18th chapter. And he invited King Jehoshaphat over for dinner. And they sat at the same table, eating the same food. And then Jehoshaphat was asked by King Ahab, listen, man, won't you do me a little favor? Since, you know, we got a relation, you know, we partly family. Will you do me a favor and would you align yourself and go to war with me? Because I want to go to war, amen, because I need me some more land, and I'm going to go to war against Ramoth at Gilead. Listen to the God-fearing man's response. Yes, of course, because you and I are just as one. How can you be just as one or almost just alike with someone that does not worship your God nor honor God as God? How do we have so much in common with ungodly people that we're willing to get pulled into their mess that has nothing to do with us? Oh, y'all don't like me. Jehoshaphat said, still giving a little bit of history, Jehoshaphat said, listen, I'm going to do that. Yes, my brother, we'll do it. We'll come and align ourselves, but won't you do just one thing? Somebody say just one thing. Let's inquire of God and see if it's okay. Let's see what God has to say about it. And so he said, listen, okay, I'll do that. But Ahab went and called his men, those that were in cahoots with him. Now, they were called prophets. Just because somebody has a title does not mean that they are in order with God. Y'all don't like me today.
And he said, well, what do they have to say? What do y'all have to say? Do y'all think we need to go to war? Do y'all think we don't need to go to war? And they said, yeah, yes, you can go to war. Matter of fact, God's going to make you victorious. You're going to win the war. Have you ever heard something and it just didn't sit right in your spirit? The Bible says that Jehoshaphat was not comfortable with that. And he said, isn't there anybody else that can speak on God's behalf on this matter? How is it that everybody's saying the same thing? That's Carolyn saying that last part. And he said, there's one more prophet, but he don't ever say nothing good. He always says something bad. But they brought him in, and this prophet said, all I'm gonna say is what God tells me to say. I just wanna ask the question, are there any people in this house that's willing to say, all I'm going to say is what God says is okay to say? All I'm going to do is what God says is okay to do. All the only places I'm going to go are the places that God condones. Watch this. We're in the 18th, going to the 19th chapter. And they went to war. Wait. Jehoshaphat, didn't you say you were going to inquire to see if it was okay for you to do that? And God answered, gave you the word, and the answer was no. Because if you go, the children in Israel are going to be like sheep without a shepherd. And if you go, King Ahab, you won't be returning. His response was, see what I told you? He ain't never got nothing good to say. Why do we ask God to give us a word and then don't obey the word that he gave us? This man asked God for direction. The Lord gave him direction and he did what he wanted to do. Y'all listen. I don't know about you, but that convicted my heart, because there's been times I've asked God, pleaded with God, God, show me the way. Tell me what to do. And then when he told me, I didn't like what I heard and did what I wanted to do anyhow. And when Jehoshaphat went to war anyhow, somebody say anyhow, against what God told him to do, he almost lost his life. And the only thing that saved him was he cried out and said, help! Thank God we live and love a God that even when we've made a mess of it, if we just call on him and say help, he'll respond to us. The 19th chapter said that he made it home in peace and safely. Then we approach the 20th chapter, and King Jehoshaphat learned his lesson. He didn't listen to God, but he said, I want to do better, and I'm going to start doing this. I'm going to start providing an atmosphere where the people that I lead can learn about this God that I love. And we're going to start setting things in order right here in the kingdom. And the Bible says this, as he puts things back to order and things are at peace, there's something in the 20th chapter that we must look at. For every leader that is in this room, whether you are a teacher, whether you're a counselor, a librarian, a parent, what else? A preacher, a deacon, or a pastor, God puts on display, using for an example King Jehoshaphat, that character is important. He puts on display the character of King Jehoshaphat. He was a good man, as I said, but he was not a perfect man. But he was a man that was learning. Beloved, we don't learn how to walk in all of the truths of God all at once. The Bible says that he wanted to do what was right, And have you ever been going through a season after a turbulent time and it looks like things are getting better, and then out of nowhere you get some bad news? Have you ever been going all that you knew for God and then encouraging those that were around you to do the same, and you all are getting a rhythm, am I talking to myself, or a stride in God, and whammy, out of nowhere your household is now under attack, and before you can regroup from one thing, you hear that something else has happened, and before you can get over that thing, now something else has happened. Beloved, that is what Jehoshaphat was going through. It wasn't just one group of things coming against him. The Bible says it was three all at once. What do you do when there's a lot going on? Your character will be on full display. And Jehoshaphat did this. He was honest with where he was, how he was feeling, and the turbulence within him. The Bible says he was fearful. He was terrified. He was alarmed. And then watch this. What I love about it, and he wasn't fake about it. He didn't have the mindset of fake it till you make it. Beloved, if you're faking it till you make it, then that means you are not authentic. You know what a hypocrite is? Somebody that fakes being someone that they are not. Oh, y'all don't like this, do you? It's gonna get good in a minute. Watch this. Here's the truth, though. We are complex and complicated individuals. And sometimes there are contradictions within us. Oh, if you didn't like that, you're not gonna like this. Because as I was studying, I saw where it said fear. Somebody say fear. Fear and faith cannot occupy the same space at the same time. Y'all like that, don't you? That fear and faith cannot occupy the same space at the same time. And yet this man who was fearful and terrified and alarmed had fear, and he had faith, because he took his fear and his terrified self to the house of God. Sometimes things are terrifying, but if we do like he did, come to God's house anyhow, come to prayer anyhow, trust God that he's big enough to handle your fear anyhow. You don't have to act like you're not scared. Sometimes things are scary, but trust God enough that you keep on coming, that you keep on believing, that you keep on pressing. Be honest enough to say, God, I don't know what to do. This is too much. It's too big. Listen, if you don't think faith and fear can occupy the same space, then why did Jesus in Matthew 8 and 26, when they were in the midst of that hard storm, why did he turn around to the disciples and say, why are you so afraid? Because y'all got a little bit of faith. It was not that they did not have faith, but they let their fear override their faith. See, the reason that faith is so important, and the reason, listen, the Bible says in Romans, amen, it says, listen, that faith cometh by hearing. Everybody say, faith cometh by hearing. But there's a comma after that. So if faith can come by hearing, fear can come by hearing. But the only thing that is distinctive against one another is that faith cometh by hearing, and it hears the message of God through the word of God. And then we develop faith in God's word. Fear develops confidence in what's going on in our lives. So the harder it gets, the more we build up faith. And the reason God does not want us to be smothered by our fear will make your faith fickle. You'll be up one day, down one day. One day God can do it and he's magnificent. And another thing, I believe he can. I'm just not sure if he will. It'll make your faith fickle. Faith is developed and strengthened by the word of God. And so we must be honest with where we are. And then secondly, we must be, we must have some humility. King Jehoshaphat had some humility. Everybody say humility. The Bible says that he was fearful and he went in the temple, but he had the audacity to trust God anyway. He trusted God and then he acknowledged his fear before God. And the Bible says he then called a fast and prayer. I can remember, Netris, almost 39 years ago, Bishop and Pastor C, I can remember us having many fasts and prayers and three-day shut-ins. We'd bring our children in. Anybody remember that? We'd have sleeping baskets. See what they're called? Sleeping things you put your kids in to sleep. We slept on the pews. We bought water. Our children left here, brushed their teeth, and went to school. We went and picked them up and came back because it was wonderful things that we were believing for the Lord. We saw people who was failing the board 4 and 5 times, but in the midst of the fasting and the prayer, they passed boards and now are magnificent. We saw marriages that had been destroyed, but then we saw them come back together while we were in the midst of prayer. There's benefits and fasting and in praying. We must just humble ourselves to do so. Somebody say humility. Humility at its best allows us, amen, to submit our way of doing things to God's way. It turns our God's mercy towards us, because the Bible says God gives more grace to the humble. Which means when you feel like you can't do anymore, God will give you some more so you can do it and get it done. Watch this. King Jehoshaphat was a good man. Oh my God. The Bible is so good. I can remember a teaching here in the church. Y'all a hard place to preach to this morning. I can remember one of the most profound messages I've ever heard in my life, because we're complicated and we're not perfect. Anybody in here perfect? We're complicated. We want to do good, but sometimes we don't. We want to get it right, but sometimes we miss it. We promise God we'll do better and then turn our mind and say, but I still want that. And one of the most powerful messages I ever heard was, you can't do what you want to do and have the real Holy Ghost too. One of the most profound messages was, you can't do what you want to do and then have the real Holy Ghost too. And the preacher that preached that, let me introduce that person to y'all, was Reverend Dr. Claudette Anderson Copeland. I couldn't get it right away, but I put it in my back pocket. And so every time I still wanted to do something I had no business doing, I'd hear something in the back of my head that would say, you can't do what you want to do and still have the Holy Ghost too. I remember, somebody say, do you remember, Carolyn? I remember being in the midst of worship and being in the midst of, I don't know if we call it a Sunday school. And for 18 long months, we went through a book called Spiritual Authority for 18 straight months. Do I have anybody that remember that? I thought I was learning and doing better. And then they talked about Moses hitting the rock and missing what God had for him because he hit the rock. And I'm like, God, I'm living the best I know. But I'm not only hitting the rock, I kick the rock, I push the rock, and if these people don't leave me alone, I'm gonna pick that same rock and I'm gonna knock somebody upside their head with it. God was still working on me. So I didn't get it right away. So I understood why God has to take a long time with some people. Would y'all tell the truth? Has the Lord taken a long time with some of your stuff that you didn't get right away? The Lord shows us our character. And then says, but will you love me enough that you humble yourself? Will you love me enough that you bring what you're going through to me and still come to church?
Or will you allow what you're going through and living through to make you miss back? Wait a minute. It was raining this morning, and the Lord spoke this to me. And he said, do you love me enough to press your way through the rain? Do you value me enough that you'll get up there knowing you don't want to wear this oxygen? Or do you think of yourself more highly than you ought to, and you have an image that you want to uphold? Do you love me enough? You ought to be asking yourself, do I love God enough that when things are not going as I would like them to go, that I still press my way all the way through? Do you love God enough that when things are not lining up, that you press your way on through? So I need to know, is there anybody this morning that had to press your way? Come on, brother. Why is that important? That we walk in a place of being honest. Why is it important that we walk in humility? Because there's something that is found in 2 Chronicles, and it is in the, I believe it's the 7th chapter in the 14th verse. And it says, if my people, talk back to me, church, if my people who are called by my name will do what? Humble themselves. Do you have enough love for God that you'll humble yourself now that you have a house, now that you have a car, now that you have a job, now that you're educated, now that your children are saved, now that things are going well? Do you love God enough? Do you think it's so wonderful that you're not willing to get up and give God some praise? If my people that are called by my name would humble themselves. The Bible says that Jehoshaphat went to the temple, called a fast, and then said, God, we love you, but we don't know what to do. Everything that we have, you're the one that gave it to us. This church, you gave it to us. The seats, you gave it to us. The people in the seats, you gave them to us. God, but now the devil, our enemy, is trying to threaten to take it all away. God, what you gonna do? Because I don't know what to do. I'm telling you what, I've been living through something and I don't know what to do, but I know what I'm not gonna do. I'm not gonna fight in a battle that don't belong to me. There are some battles that belong to the Lord. When the enemy comes against you and lifts up a standard, the Lord we love, hey, comes in like a flood. It was raining this morning. Somebody say it's raining. God is still raining down promises. God is still raining down blessings. But you've got to humble yourself. Somebody give him glory. I need to hear some glory. I need to hear some glory. Come on, come on, come on. If your feet work, you ought to be standing up and giving God glory. Humble yourself. Somebody in this room say, oh man, don't make me stand up. My back hurts. Listen, my chest hurts. My feet hurts. My spine hurts. But there are some things that are just worthy of us giving God praise. So if I can stand up with a death warrant over my head, I better see somebody in this church giving my God praise, giving my God glory. Somebody shout glory. Hey. Somebody shout glory. I feel like lifting them up. I feel like giving them praise because I'm in the safety of the ark. We're in his house. Watch this. I gotta catch my breath. There was a mother in my church in Arkansas. She's gone on to be with the Lord. And when I was, this is not my first round with cancer. This is actually my second. And one time I was preaching, Bishop and Pastor C,
but I couldn't catch my breath. And I said, I sure do want to run. And Mother Emma Carter said, Pastor C, I'll run for you. And she got up out of her seat and she began running laps around the church. And I said, take one more for me. I'm not going to ask anybody to run, but will somebody just leap for joy real quick for me? One good time. Thank you, Jesus. Never would have made it. Never would have made it this far if it had not been for the Lord. Hey, that's on my side. Touch somebody, say, you don't know what I've been through. You don't know what I'm going to. Look at somebody, say, you don't know what I've been through. Look at somebody, look at somebody. You don't know what I'm going through. But do you know this? That no matter what I've been through, no matter what I'm going through, that my God is still on my side. Give him glory. Give him glory. Yes. 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 The Bible. Be seated, beloved. Hey, 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 hey. Somebody shout glory for me one good time, because I feel it down in my bosom. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The reason it is so important for us to learn to humble ourselves and be honest about where we are in God is because in the book of Chronicles, the Bible says, if my people who are called by my name would humble themselves and seek my face, turn from their wicked ways. Somebody say, then God will hear from heaven. Not only did he humble himself, not only was he honest, be seated, beloved. Not only was he honest and humble, but the Bible says he went in the temple, Bishop and Pastor C, not only just to pray, but he went to seek God. And seeking God means to pursue him. And you don't let go of him till you get what you want from him. I can't do it right now, but give me just two people real quick. Would y'all do it, LaDonna and my sister here? Act like you, God. I know, I know, I know. I know he's still working on you, but come on. Act like you. What's she gonna get me for that? Move up a little bit. Now you wanna seek God. Keep going. Come on over here. But if she wanna seek him, you ain't gotta look at her, turn around. You God, she's seeking you. See what we do? But he said, no, I don't want you to do that anymore, because what you need for me is so big. I want you to run after me like your life is dependent on it. Quit coming at me any kind of way. I want you to seek me like your life depends on it. Now, LaDonna, you walk down that aisle a little bit. Now, you go after God like you want something from him. That's what God wants from us. And then he's saying, and don't you dare stop. Don't you dare stop. Don't you dare quit till you get from me what you wanted. And then if you have not received from the Lord what it is that you want, don't you dare stop. High five your own self and say, you better not stop. You better keep on going till you receive what you want from the Lord. My God, oh God, my God. The Bible says, watch this, because he was honest, because he was humble. Kai, five minutes. Because he was honest and he was humble. Watch this. The Bible says God heard. He didn't even listen till humility came on board. Because God resists the proud. He don't care nothing about you praying every day if you won't humble yourself before him. He resists the proud. That's why you keep going over the same stuff over and over and over again. Aren't you tired of being on that merry-go-round? Humble yourself and say, God, I don't know what to do, but I'm going to give it all to you. Ah, the Bible says, somebody say, the Bible says that God heard. And then I got to run. Oh, my God. Thank you. I got to run. Somebody say, help the Lord. Help the Lord. The Bible said God heard. And when we put ourselves
in the right place with God, he not only will hear, but the Lord will answer quickly. The Bible says that God answered quickly. But when we have been individuals that have been around people that have been inauthentic and people that have pulled us into stuff and we were not the better for it, you'll learn your lesson. There's something that I learned. It's only so far that those of us that love God is going to go before the Lord says, okay, keep going. You say, no, I'm going back to God. Forget that. I love you, baby. I got to go. Yeah, we still family. We cool. One, deuces. But I got to go. Somebody this morning needs to say, deuces, bye-bye. I got to go. I got to give all of me to God. Not part of me. He's not my sugar daddy. He's my father among fathers. He's my mind regulator. He's the heartbeat of my soul. When is the last time you made love to your God? God is saying, do you love me enough? Watch this. And so he sent word. And he sent word to someone that is a praiser. What the Lord is getting ready to do is going to be so magnificent that, baby, we have to position ourselves now to be ready to praise him. And God sent someone that's a praiser. But he didn't send just anybody, because some of us have been through some things. Am I talking to anybody? We don't want to hear no more prophets and then got to pay them $500 for that prophecy. We don't want to hear from no more prophets that ain't never in prayer, never come to Bible study. Oh, we want to hear from somebody that loves God enough that they love God and lay out for him even when it ain't nothing they going to get out of it except seeing your life better. So God selected someone by the name of Jehaziel. He was a son of Zechariah, but he came from a lineage of worshipers. Somebody say worshipers. Matter of fact, one of he is the descendant of someone named Asher. And Asher is important because Asher was the musician and one of the psalmists that played for and sang for in the temple for King David. And so God won't just select just anybody that's going to be a blessing in this season. They have to be a worshiper and they have to have a history with God so that God could have had time to work out their idiosyncrasies. Because if we tell the truth, all of us have them. And this is what he said on God's behalf. Somebody say, because a miracle is getting ready to happen. And the Bible says that this prophet stood up who had never been this bold, but he was in the meeting and he said, listen, do not be afraid and do not be discouraged because of this army that's coming against you. For this battle is not yours, but it's the Lord. And then watch this, God will give us a word and then he'll give us some instruction. The word was, you don't have to fight in this battle. That this one is God's. And then said, but on tomorrow, somebody say tomorrow, this is what I want you to do. I want you to go out. And God showed them where the enemy was going to be. Watch this. Isn't it amazing? God help me stand again. Isn't it amazing that the Lord will have us, amen, that the Lord will have us to stand and confront the thing that's been opposing us without another promise from him. He wants to know, do you love me enough that you'll get in position even though you don't know how it's going to turn out? Do you love me enough that you're willing to get in position and stay there? This time, don't get out of position when it gets scary. Do you love me enough that you'll get in position until the victory is won, even when it looks like you may not win? Tell somebody, time to get in position, because God's getting ready to do something. But he said, this battle is not yours, it's the Lord's. Remember the time, as I get ready to close, when you gave someone all you knew to give them and then they laughed in your face. Remember the time you shared what you had with someone and they didn't do you right. Remember the time you couldn't pay your bills and you asked God, would he help you? Am I talking to anybody in the house? And he made a way out of no way.
on your behalf. And he said, all I'm asking is for 10%. And then you say, but I don't have it. He said, but do you love me enough that even though you think you don't have it, that you'll trust me enough that I'll open up the windows of heaven and I'll pour you out a blessing that there won't be room enough to receive? Do you love me enough that you'll stop throwing little bitty this and that at me? Do you love me enough and do you trust me enough that I'll touch somebody and they'll bless you, and they'll bless you so much the blessing will be pressed down, shaken together, and running over? Somebody ask yourself, do you love God enough that you'll get in position and not get out of position? Hallelujah. The Bible says he told them to get in position and watch and see what Jehoshaphat did. He said, everybody, I want y'all to listen, because if you trust God, we're going to come out of this thing prosperous, because the Lord has already promised us that we're not going to have to fight in this battle. He's already said he's taking all of this personally. He just wants us to show up. Somebody say, show up. The Lord just wants us to show up so he can do a miracle in front of our face. And they showed up. That was on yesterday that God gave the word. But today is the day that the miracle is getting ready to happen. Today, on this anniversary day, God is saying, everything that's been bothering you and plaguing you, you ain't got to take it personal no more, because they dared to mess with you and you my child. God said, I got it. Somebody say, do your thing, God. He said, I got it. You don't have to get offended anymore. I've got it. But do you love me enough that you'll do one thing for me? Will you forgive the person that has done you wrong? Do you love me enough that you'll take a position of forgiving? No, well, you don't know what they did to me. You don't know what they did to me. Pastor Carol, now you're going too far. No. I don't have to know what you went through, because I know what I went through. I told y'all, this is not my first time having cancer. And someone that I loved stood in my face the first time and told me they didn't care. They were not gonna go to meet with me to any appointments, and they kept their word. I told y'all I used to be the one that would kick the rock, shout the rock. I want to throw the rock, except I've been walking with God for a long time, and picking up the rock and throwing it wasn't even in my hand. I just heard the Spirit of the Lord say, don't say nothing. Sometimes we gotta let God handle it. I know you like things in your control, but I hear God saying, let God handle it, because this battle is not yours. This battle belongs to the Lord. The Bible says that they stood there, but before they stood, the Bible says that King Jehoshaphat bowed his head and worshiped God, and then the people followed suit. Beloved, it's time for those of us in God's house to humble ourselves before God, because praising anybody can say hallelujah, but only somebody with a close-knit relationship with God. Because worshiping God has nothing to do with what we sing. It's a posture down in our hearts. They worship God. And then the Bible says, he said, get in this place, but say nothing else except God's mercy endureth forever. And the more they said God's mercy endureth forever, the things that had them bound began to die. The things that had them upset began to die. God will make the things that's been coming up against us turn on itself. Somebody say, thank you, Jesus. But God said, this battle is not yours. It belongs to God. Watch this. As I take my seat for real, the Lord said, this battle is not yours. It belongs to him. Because this is not about you getting more stuff. He's done enough. He's given you cars and houses and lands, jobs. Everything you've wanted, he's given. But you won't give him any time.
He said, do you love me enough that you give me some of your time? Do you love me enough when you sing, with every breath, I'll sing of your goodness. But when I nudge you at night, you turn over and say, I'm too tired. He said, this battle is about because I won't destroy you, but my loving you is now hurting me. That's the word of the Lord. You've been in a relationship with God a long time. So why are we still treating him like we don't need him? He said, so before you claim something else, look at that field. Look what I've done for you. They couldn't pick up all of those. They couldn't pick up everything that was in the field in one day. It took them 3 days. There'll be some things that we still have to work through. But do you love God enough? Because he's saying, I've done it before. I'll bless you again. But you've treated me badly before. Are you going to do it again? Because this is my battle. Because my church is turning into a club. I've taken a lot, but now God is saying it's time to get back in alignment with him and his goodness and his mercy.
Put your hands together and bless God. Come on and let's give God a hand clap of praise for the word. Listen, I'm going to ask everyone to stand in this sanctuary. You have heard the word of God. And there's a challenge in that word. I jotted it down as Pastor Carolyn was preaching. And it said, God has been extremely patient with me. I don't know who it is. Come on, elders, we're getting ready to have the altar call. Maybe you're in the balcony, maybe you're here, you're around. God has been extremely patient with you. He's been waiting for you to accept him as Lord and Savior of your life. You say, well, I've been living a good life. But I hear him saying it hadn't been my life for you. You're here today and you don't know him as Lord and Savior. Wherever you are, you need to come right now. He's been patient with you. I want you to come. Just come meet me here at the altar. Maybe you have accepted him. You need to rededicate your life. You haven't been running like you should after him. Come on. Come on. Wherever you are, you haven't been pursuing him. Something has caused you to be hindered in your pursuit of God. You got pulled into some things that you had no business being pulled into because it had nothing to do with God. You're here today. You're in the right place at the right time. I want you to come wherever you are. I want to meet you right here in this place. Come. I want to rededicate my life. Come on. Come on, brother. Come on, I want to meet y'all right here. I want to meet you. Come on. Come on. Let's praise God for him. Praise God. Come on. Where are you? Where are you? Come from wherever you are. There's a pursuit that God has for you. I want you to come and meet me wherever you are. Come on. Come boldly. Come quickly. We've got to press on. I know you're here. I know you're here. Come quickly. There's a pursuit. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. There's a pursuit that God has for you. Bless him. Bless him. There's a pursuit. Yeah, there it is. There it is. They're coming. Come on. Come on. There's a pursuit. God has not forgotten y'all. He has not forgotten. Come on. Come on. Elders, you begin to pray for them. Come on. This is the pool right here. This is where we are. The Lord is saying, I need you to come. I need you to come because there's a desire that's in you that God has placed there. And something has caused your pursuit to halt. Something has caused your pursuit to slow down. Come on. Come on. Come on. Wherever you are in this place, come on, saints. If you pray, they'll come. If you pray, they'll come. They'll come. All in the balcony, wherever you are. This is us. Come meet us. Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus. That's what this is about right now. Come to Jesus. Come on, come on. From all over the place, you need a place that you can call home. This is a great church, a place that will hold you accountable to the Word of God. The Lord, the doors, as they used to say in the old church, the doors of the church are open. They just want you to come now. Come on, come on, come on. Can y'all, come on, praise team, can y'all help me with this? Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus just now. Come on, they're still coming. Just now. Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus just now. Come on, come on. Anybody else? Come. He's able.
He is able. He is able. He is able just now. Just now. He is able.
One more time, just come to Jesus. Come, come.
Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus. Just now. Just now. Come to Jesus. Come to Jesus. Just now.
For those of you that are watching online, you know, this may be an opportunity. This is an opportunity for you. You can email at yes@nccf-sa.org. Someone will reply to you. If you can't get that, just drop something in the chat. Let them know, I need Jesus as Lord and Savior. I rededicated my life. I want to be a member of New Creation Christian Fellowship. The team will reach out to you, and we will reach and connect with you so that you can become a part of the family. Well, come on and put your hands together and bless God. Let's get a quick report this morning or this afternoon.
Praise the Lord, New Creation and Pastor Hunt. We have with us Shayla, who's a former member of the church who went away to college, who's now come back to rededicate her life to the Lord.
Good morning, New Creation. This is Emma and Sasha, and they just came up to get prayer so that they can get closer to the Lord. Cliff T, this is your group right here, sir.
He just came for prayer.
Praise the Lord, saints. This is Fiona, and this is her daughter, Alicia, and they came to give their lives to the Lord. Well, they want to become members. Amen.
Well, praise the Lord, New Creation Christian Fellowship. Come on and put your hands together and bless God for what he has done in this great place. Listen, I want to encourage this brother as we get ready to give this back over to Pastor. Say, brother, right here. Come here, real quick. You be encouraged in what God has for you. Others have said you should not be where you are or doing what you are doing. But I hear the Lord saying, I've got you in this. He says, run after me. like you've never ran. Your life depends on it. He says, run and pursue after me. Don't be concerned about what others will think or what others will do. He says, run after me and watch me make it right. Run after me and watch your feet get light like never before. Run after me and watch the blessings and the promises of God unfold. He says, be encouraged and be strengthened by what I am getting ready to do. But it relies on your pursuit of him. Be encouraged and know that God is going to be with you. All right, be his strength. Come on, new creation, bless God. Bless him. I don't know, who am I giving this to? Right here. Okay, all right.
Yes, Pastor C and I are going to come together.
Thank you.
Praise Lord. Glory. Clap your hands for Pastor Carolyn Ramsey. She said, I got a death warrant over my life, but I love God enough to keep pressing my way. Thank you for the word of the Lord to us this morning, Pastor Carolyn. We love you and we're praying for you. And let me tell you what, God has so blessed some of us, many of us. We are living with what other people died from. God's grace is sufficient because we love him enough to keep coming after him. I'm going to give it to Elder Annette just a moment. But let me tell you something. I asked Deacon Bonner to be in the house with us this morning, and he's so faithful. He came in a minute ago and then he ran out. I don't know where he went. But would y'all tell him that because Founders Day is not just about us, but we also always want to be a blessing. What's on the ground is Bishop and I desiring to be a blessing. We want to be a blessing to Bishop, to Deacon Bonner, to say thank God for his years of service and faithfulness. And I don't know where he went to.
He's counting.
He counting other people's money, and I'm trying to give him some money. Who's the next deacon? Deacon, come and get this for Deacon Bonner and tell him his pastors and his church family love him a whole lot. And on Founders Day, we wanted to honor him. Would you let him know? Clap your hands. Be in the hands of Elder Annette Benjamin.
God bless you, Pastor C. Okay, saints of God, Reverend Dr. Claudette Anderson Copeland and David Michael Copeland, our founders. Pastor, Bishop, thank you. Thank you so much for the positive impact that you're not only doing for the community, but how you have strengthened us as a church family. Thank you. And we recognize the sacrifice that you all do to be able to serve this body, New Creation Christian Fellowship. Right, family? Amen. We love and appreciate you both, Bishop and Pastor. Department heads, this is now your opportunity to come and place your offerings for your departments here and bring them for our founders. And then, of course, NCCF family, you too will have an opportunity thereafter. Department heads, you all come at this time. And I'll begin with discipleship. Do you mind, Carol, putting that in there for you, please? Thank you, love. And now, NCCF family, you're welcome to come as well. Come on, from all over the house. Let our bishop and our pastor know how much we love them. And for my digital friends, look on the screens. We should have their cash apps up there. For Claudette Anderson Copeland, it is $ Rev Dr. CAC. And for our bishop, it is $ POPCOPE. That is Pope Cope. Amen. All over the house. Have your cards. Yes, put them in the baskets. Have your note to them. Let them know how much you love and appreciate each and every one of them. God bless you, NCCF family. Amen. Keep coming from all over the house. Amen.
Come on, all in the balcony.
That's right. Come on, y'all, come on down. Bring your cards down. Amen. Yep. Let's fill up that basket. I love it. Fill it up. Fill it up. And don't forget, we have their cash apps on the screen for you. I know we do have digital partners. Amen, saints of God. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. That's your note to them, to let you know how you feel about them. Amen. Amen. So thank you, people of God, NCCF family and friends, for your outpouring of love and your demonstration of adoration for our pastors. Now I'll take the opportunity to bless this. Heavenly Father, bless these gifts and the givers on behalf of our bishop and our pastor. Truly, truly, they are a blessing to our lives. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen. Amen. God bless you, Bishop and Pastor. We love you.
With me right now. We want to thank every single person again for your generosity, for your kindness, for those who gave and those who did not have to give, those who desire to give, and those who will at a later date. We thank God for you that you will lose nothing for having sown into the man and the woman of God. Sister Slater, are you here back? Somebody, Bishop said you were here. The Bishop just wanted to acknowledge this is a giving day, giving to your leaders, and she gave a major sacrifice. One kidney for him, one kidney left for her. We love you and honor you for all that you do. Listen to me, I need you direct, need you to listen. Every single person that is here, we want to serve you. Our unhoused population is here on the grounds. We've started serving them already before the benediction. When you go out, would you please be patient? Go to every table, and if there's a little line, wait, because you need to be screened, even though I'm a witness. You think you're doing fine. You don't know what might be hidden in your body. Let them screen you. Be patient, be kind, and allow others, amen, to be served by the hardworking team of the Women's Educational and Healing Retreats. We thank you so much. We're going to be doing good things all year long. The Pipersburgs are home for a little while. We're going to be partnering with Belize so we can do a good work down there. This is a mission-minded church. We don't make a lot of noise about it, but we try to do good everywhere we can. Again, Pastor Ramsey, thank you so much for your labor with us this morning. And we thank God for continuing to cause you to live, to cause you to live. Let's stand. It's time to go. It's time to go. It's time to go. Look, we worked harder up here than y'all did. I said stand and thank God for all that has happened today.
Listen, new creation has approximately $400,000 miracle need. So I'm going to ask you this week, next Sunday's first Sunday, that this week, everybody who will, I want to raise, this is not anything we got on the table now, but I want to raise $40,000. So I'm going to ask every one of you to go home and pray and ask God what you can do to help us with this miracle need. Trust me, I'll tell you more about it next week, but I want to give you a week to go to God. This is not your tithe. This is not the offering. This is not all of that other stuff. This is something that's going to go out of the house so that God can bless our house. Now unto him who is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before the only wise God, our Savior, to him be glory, majesty, dominion, and power. Thank you, God, for 39 years, and we're going to bless you in the 40th. In Jesus' name, go into peace, and the Lord go with you.
Thank you so much for joining us today. You know, you're always welcome at New Creation Christian Fellowship to worship with us in the presence of the Lord. I hope you had an impactful experience today. please tune in again with us during our Sunday morning worship at 10 a.m. and Wednesday night Bible study at 7 p.m. Hey, we'll see you next time. God bless.